Screencastify has a lot of options for sharing the video. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a few of them. First thing is once you've finished and you've done stop sharing, that's the link right there, it will take you to this screen. From this screen, you can cut out pieces if you want. So you can trim it, you can edit the video. And then once you have it set exactly the way that you want, you can copy a shareable link from your Google Drive and you can post that in the discussion board. Or if you want to get really slick, you could set up a YouTube channel and you can keep it unlisted if you want. And you can upload and publish directly to YouTube. And then you'll be able to embed the YouTube link directly into Canvas. The other option that you could have is you can export it as an MP4. What that will do is that will export the file onto your desktop. And then you'll be able to upload that file into Canvas in the discussion board area. So you have several different options with that. For this first one, I'm just going to go ahead and choose copy shareable link. If you want help with the publishing to YouTube, let me know and I'll record a video on that as well. So I'm going to copy the shareable link. So let's just put the copy of it, because what's happened is with Screencastify, it's actually putting it into a folder in your Google Drive. And there's the first one. So with this, I may want to rename this just so it makes it a little bit easier. I'm just going to do this one as Pinterest. Just go a Pinterest board or something like that, just so I can keep track of it. And then I'll click OK. And then I'll close that. But I've already copied. In fact, I'm just to be safe, I'm going to come back here and I'm going to copy the shareable link just in case by changing the file name it messed something up. And then from there, I'll end up going into my Canvas account. So I'm just using the photo one for right now. If you're in the graphic design class, it's going to be the same thing. What you'll do is you'll come over to your discussions. And from the discussions, here's the key thing with the way that these discussions are set up. You have these threads. And what I mean by threads is there's different sections within the challenges. So within this first challenge, what you're going to do is you're going to reply, but you're not going to reply to this top one. You're going to reply to the specific challenge that you're doing. And right now we're doing the Pinterest Behance board screencast. So what you're going to do is you're going to click on reply here. And I'm going to do here is my screencast. And then I'm just going to highlight the word screencast and I'm going to click on link to URL. And I'll go ahead and paste that in there. And then I'll insert the link. And then you'll post the reply. Now, if you got fancy and you did the YouTube piece, you can see here's the YouTube link right here. And you can paste not the link from the Google Drive, but you'll paste directly from the embed YouTube piece. So if you want help with the YouTube one, let me know. I will record something for you. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just do cancel. And then right here, here's my screencast, and I'm going to post the reply. So that now when I click on this, what will happen is it will open up the video that I can play directly.
And now it is actually recording.
That is annoying to hear my own voice. So that's how you will set it up using Screencastify. If you're using a different application, we'll do something very similar, but I'll record that in a different video.